Happy Easter, everyone! This is Sister Menen Alarcon of the Daughters of St. Paul for today's Gospel Power.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit."
Brothers and sisters, Jesus says in John 6:44, "No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me." Thus, the visit of Nicodemus is not his own initiative, but divinely predetermined. His coming at night is symbolic. He can glimpse at the eternal light but approaches it with caution, afraid to leave the security of the darkness represented by his elite Pharisaic sect and its separatist vision of holiness, not wishing to be caught associating with Jesus and listening to his teaching. Nicodemus cloaks their meeting in the obscurity of the night. As a character in John's Gospel, he represents those who are ambivalent about Jesus. Though strongly attracted to him, they are prevented from committing their lives to him by realities that offer them security, perhaps their career, relationships, possessions, ideologies, or anything that prevents them from stepping into the broad daylight of faith and discipleship. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you have freed us from darkness by your death and resurrection. Help us to live as children of light and of day. Amen.
We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us, make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever.